Okay, so today's topic, as in the beginning you all have seen, it is related to music and everybody likes it, right? So music, and the first thing that music comes to us is through the sound. So today in science we are going to study about the topic science, sound, and there are two objectives. First one is we will be learning sound produced by a vibrating body. Okay, without a vibrating body the sound cannot be produced. And the second topic that we will explain is sound produced by humans. What all sounds that are produced by humans, that we will see. Okay, let's move further. Now before that, let us understand, suppose if you have the guitar at your home and other musical instruments, so everything must be having some string, and when you move that string, the string vibrates and the sound is produced, right? But how does it come to our ears? What is that thing that brings that sound to us? That is the medium. So air acts as the medium for the sound to propagate, and without any medium, the sound will never propagate at all. Let's move to the next part. Now we will be just talking about the experience with musical instruments. So let it be a guitar, let it be a tabla, let it be a flute. So for everything we need the vibration. Vibration of sound is needed. That is why the music is produced. Okay. Now, as we have discussed that sound needs a medium to propagate. So the sound also travels through the solid thread of a can telephone. You must have done this exercise. You must have played this game when you were very young. You must have used the small cups, right? The paper cups or the thermocol cups that used to come. And when we tie the string to it, then what happens when the two children, even when they are far away from each other, at that time also the sound travels from one side to the other side, means from the cup which is in one hand. Can you see this picture over here? The first picture, two children are playing that game, right? So in that case the string is acting as the medium, right? And for us, when like I am talking to you and if something is happening, so for that the air is acting as the medium to propagate, right? Okay, now we will also learn about noise and music. Okay, initially when the music was getting played, you all appreciated, you all liked it because it was a music, right? So the sound which is pleasing to ears is called musical sound, and it is produced by regular vibration. There has to be some system, there has to be one regularity, and rhythmically it produces. Now, what can be the possible example? Sound produced by musical instrument and the sound of a singing choir, right? Or even if a person is singing, the nightingale is singing, that is the musical sound. Now if we talk about the noise is the unpleasant sound, we can say, and it is produced by irregular vibrations. So if all the students in the class, it must be happening in your school also, when they all start speaking together, you will not like it, right? Even the horns, the traffic jam, it is unpleasant because of the noise. Now next, we have some capacity, right? If we talk about human beings, it is not written correctly here. It should be 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz, right? The first line, there is a correction. Now the sound whose frequency is less than 20 hertz, we can't hear it, right? As human being, and these are called infrasonic sound. And animals like dog, elephant, rhinoceros, whales produces and hear infrasonic sound, right? That is why you must have seen dogs. They will react to some of the sounds and some of the vibrations which we can't hear. Sound whose frequency is more than 20,000 hertz. There is a correction here, please make a note of it. That is called the ultrasonic sound. Animals like dolphins, bats, rats, and these all sound animals, they produce ultrasonic sound, which that is also not audible to us, right? Now sound is very important, okay? And we get to hear the sound through a medium. When the vibrating body produces a sound, then we get to hear it. And even in our ears, we have something very special. So due to that special thing, we can easily hear that sound which is getting produced. Okay, and that is what? That is the eardrum. Okay, and now in the next class we will be talking about the sound.